Good late afternoon to everyone in Asia. Good morning or buongiorno to everyone in Italy. And I guess it's still nighttime in North America and South America. But I welcome all of you that are attending this. I guess it's our fourth webinar where we're focusing in on primarily telco products. And today we will be featuring our third presentation. We'll deal with the Telco Thalna medium power TV transmitters. And, you know, medium is relative depending upon what your broadcast group is that you're trying to capture. So we will be discussing analog and digital and the various configurations of the products that make together something unique and special for your country. So this broadcast is primarily intended for people in Asia Pacific area, which is a really large group from New Zealand, including Australia. You know, this, you know, you'll always hear Australia and New Zealand, but I'm gonna put New Zealand first. Up to Japan, and then the other part of the triangle will land in the western part of India. So it encompasses strong areas of growth in digital TV in Southeast Asia right now, including Malaysia, including Indonesia, Thailand, Singapore, Taiwan and other areas where things are moving. And, you know, I just want to point out something that we are in a COVID environment right now, where, you know, we're not through this and who knows where we're going to be, but Elanos Group is dedicated to do these seminars and we will continue to do them through the course of the stay at home work we're doing. Which may be around for a while. It works great for a lot of people. Additionally, we're going to continue to do these seminars anyways because they're working great. And during the process, we're doing a lot of smaller seminars. So by listening to this, if you think this is the type of forum that you want to get your customer and say, hey, I want to do this kind of presentation to one of my customers, a group from 10 up to 30, 100, whatever you want to do, we're welcome to do that. And we are in a couple areas. We have had our local partners have put together more detailed seminars where we'll focus in on the marketing group, for example, and talk about procurement. Then the technical groups, and then thirdly, maintenance and installation. So we can do something really custom for you. And, you know, this is not meant to be a commercial, but, you know, we can do anything with this technology today. And let's do it. So today, I'll say that because this will be primarily focused on a lot of technical stuff, we're going to dive deeper today. For those that you attended the original couple of webinars, I'm going to try to buzz through some of the review of the products for those that didn't attend. But this one, we're going to take a deep dive. And Alberto's going to go as deep as he can get into this and still maintain the attention of our audience. So again, welcome. Swati Cobb here from Thailand. Buenos dias from anybody that speaks Spanish here. I can't speak Chinese, so forget that. Zdravstvuyte, anybody coming in from Russia. So for that, let's move ahead here. Just a brief one again. I'm not going to talk about the history of the companies. I think most of you know the Elanos and Atelco names now, and certainly BE has been a major place in the marketplace for broadcast. So today we've joined these illustrious groups together in a really nice working team, contributing professionally on new product development. And I'll tell you, from a guy, from an engineer that's in a sales position, boy, I'm just really getting excited about some of the things that I see beyond this that are coming. So, what we saw in the last 10 years with efficiency, what we've seen in through Pro Television and Atelco with different digital technologies for TV broadcast, we have other things coming that are really going to change the tide of how we do business today. And I'll just mention, for example, that typically we lived in a world where we always did 1+1 protection for everything, especially on TV. You don't want to go off air. It's not a good thing. On the other hand, it's becoming more and more expensive to do that, especially digitally, because it takes more capital and more expenses to run a high-powered digital terrestrial TV broadcast system, even satellites. So today and in the past, we like to link anything digital up, synchronize it. We have a few choices today. We can either do it by radio links, via microwave, terrestrial. We can do it through internet, which is sometimes a little bit more difficult with the location of our sites. But finally, today, just make it clear that, you know, we've set a gauntlet down here now that we have available and making available across our product line satellite interfaces. We find that, and we've seen this to be very, very successful for synchronous transmissions. So let's move on to the next here. I should mention that it's growing, but I don't add to this in the last few months. But 60,000 installations, 130 countries, with the various groups we have together, 90 years of experience, which is I'm catching up to that number, but not there. And 20 centers of excellence. And I should mention this time a little bit about the centers of excellence, and that a few of them are listed here. One of them, which is BTSI in the Philippines, and we also have Clyde Broadcast, who's over in Europe. And you know, these groups dedicate themselves to taking care of regions and becoming extensions of the Alamos Group. And in fact, we expect them to be to do a local first contact great job. So they can do maintenance, they can do repair, they can do troubleshooting, and so forth. And beyond this seminar and beyond what we do from the marketing point of view and shipping a product, these groups are really helpful, and I thank them for being around to support us. So so what we're going to do now is go into the product lines. I'm going to go right into the Thalma instead of going through the other products first, but we will touch on some of the items like the exciters and the gap fillers and so forth that surround the Thalma, although you probably would not use a high-powered gap filler. But let's move on with this here. What's really neat, this product line here, and you can see we've got UHF in combination of analog and digital offerings, and all in one rack cabinet. And we can see that we can go from 700 watt average up to 5.6 digital, 8.4 analog. So pretty wide across the board. This covers a lot of the major capital or semi-capital markets that you'll be broadcasting to, depending upon what you do in your head end, and we're kind of transparent to that, and what you do in the head end, as long as we get your package across to your audience. So as you can see, comes in various sizes. The more power you have, of course, the more expensive it is. beyond the Thalna here, and we'll be talking about that next week, is Nortia, which is the with the liquid cooled, and we'll go into detail on that. So here's a broad look of what we will be talking about today at various sizes. You can see in a rack here, and I'll use my arrow here. Hopefully this is working for us. And we have the control and the exciters up here and the HPAs. Obviously, the power broadcasting isn't how many HPAs you have. People say, a transmitter is really here, and these are boosters really for the transmitters. There's a lot of secrets that Alberto will talk about and what we do to get more out of the PAs. Today, we want to say that the standard in this product line would make sense to be Doherty type pallets in order to get more efficiency today. However, we have still two options to be able to go with non-Doherty and Doherty. So Alberto will be touching on that. This slide here talks about air-cooled, and today we certainly in the UHF range can still, at these lower powers, still do a lot of air-cooled. So you can see the insides of these racks if you were to take away some of the panels, and here's a front view and a side view here, and you can look at the various elements in here. And from the back, you can see that it gets to be quite complex. So the airflow, because we have a air extractor at the top of the unit, will pull the air up to the top. We have a front-to-back flow that's going on in each of the devices, and then we pull up everything to the top. And here you can see an air extractor here, and you can choose, to dissipate this into the air or by attaching it into some ducting, square or round ducting technique. Now here you can look at the flow from front to back, from left to right in this slide, and see the air just move out through the top. Let's see, nextly, we will be talking about, at this point, I want Alberto to jump in and talk about the block diagram as how far as we configure system by system. And basically, it's fairly simple. Once you've got your exciter or your backup exciter together, and your interfaces here, and RF switches and so forth, it becomes an issue of how you put together all the high power amplifiers. So Alberto, you want to take it from here and just give me an idea when you want to advance the slide, okay?
Yeah, thank you very much, Frank. Thanks to everybody, and especially thanks for joining us in this webinar. We will start, as my colleague and friend Frank anticipated, that we are talking today about the air-cooled Thalna line transmitters. Basically, we have this configuration that is available, of course, up to two power amplifiers in 24 unit rack cabinet, or when we increase the power in 40 units rack cabinet, in order to have this enough space to locate all the power amplifiers. Generally, this configuration, it is available, of course, with in UHF or VHF band. According to what Frank anticipated, we have two opportunity to deliver the standard AB class power amplifiers, where the band is from 470 megahertz up to 860. And here we can talk about an efficiency that is around 25% the overall efficiency of the power of the transmitter, or other way, we can propose the dirty mode operation for the power amplifiers. And in this case, the band is this wide band too, but it is limited to 690 mega, because basically the configuration, the band configuration around the world is moving, is changing a little bit according to the incoming of the mobile phones operator. So one of the most important elements of this transmitter that we show in the previous slides is the scalability of the power. So basically this means that we have a lot of common elements for all the transmitter. For instance, the CCU, the control transmitter unit, the central control unit for the transmitter is same for all the transmitters. The exciters is same for all the transmitters and the power amplifiers as well. So by the matching, the combining of these power amplifiers, we can grow up with the output power. Basically, the digital modulator is capable, so the transmitter consequently is capable for analog or digital transmission just by the pushing of the button. All the elements have been specially configured. And the transmitter offers an important advantage that is the hot swappable power amplifiers in order to be capable to do an extremely fast and easy maintenance in case that something unluckily broke. And in addition to this, we have the big advantage to have an extremely good performance from our linear and non-linear precorrection. That is something really useful in the application of the field. Can we move to the next, please?
Thank you. Absolutely.
Thank you very much. Perfect. In this case, we are looking about the 40 units rec cabinet. So basically starting from three power amplifier modules, 4, 5, 6, and 8 units, we can grow up in order to improve the output power. Next, please. Next again. Perfect. So here we can have a front, the side, and the back view of the transmitter. We can easily see the configuration and the movement of the air. All our transmitters are equipped with a top air extractor. Then with the additional duct, we can duct the exhaust air outside of the transmitting station. Of course, the rack are fully wired in order to accept all the modules inside without any additional external unit, except the radio frequency output filter that, due to the digital technology, to the digital application for the digital transmission, today the filters becomes big, and in this case they are not. It is not anymore possible, physically speaking, to locate the radio frequency cavity filter inside of the transmitter. So generally, this one is generally located outside, and it can be in conformity with the customer requirement in 6-pole or 8-poles configuration for the critic mask shape. Can we move to the next, please? Perfect. So here we can have a block diagram. As you can see, is really the same of the previous one. So only the power amplifiers change. We have the same exciter. The CCU, the central control unit, is capable to manage the double exciter configuration. But with an additional software, we will see this later on. With an additional software, the central control unit can also manage the 1+1 or the N+1 transmitter configuration. So at the end, on the right of the block diagram, we can see the splitting and the combining of the power amplifier modules. Please, Frank, can you move to the next? Perfect. This is the power amplifier drawer. So basically, in this configuration, this power amplifier drawer is a multi-standard operation. So this means that it's capable for all the digital standards. It's available in UHF or VHF band. It's fully broadband in both the configuration AB class or dirty mode operation. In case of the a dirty mode operation, we have a high efficiency that can join the overall efficiency of 37%. It is auto pluggable. And we have inside an extremely good redundancy about the power amplifier stages, because we have inside three pallets combined, three radio frequency pallets combined. Each radio frequency pallet has two devices on it. Perfect. Can you move to the next? Okay, this is the central control unit. Basically, this all through a CAN bus protocol, all the information of the transmitter, so basically of each unit, the exciter, the power amplifier, and so on, all the information are addressed to the central control unit. This unit with the touch screen has an extremely intuitive and friendly user synoptic configuration. So basically, by the touch, you can check all the parameters. As you can see in the slide here, you have an extremely intuitive graphic synoptic that make you able to understand easily and in a few minutes, just by a watching of the screen, the position, the configuration, the status of the entire part of the transmitters. So basically, starting from the exciter, if it's single or double, its configuration, if you have any trouble, any warning or any alarms, basically we go to classify to consider the warning as something that is not regular, but it doesn't stop the transmitter. And on the other side, we have the alarms that are something of more consistent, not regular status, not regular transmitter status. As you can see in the middle of the configuration, you have couple of triangulars that the blue one that represent the power amplifiers, and in that case there are two and after lines and another one. This means that in the middle, according to the configuration of the transmitter with 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 etc. modules, you will have the configuration, and by pushing on these triangulars, you can come inside and you can have a complete view of the all elements of the single power amplifier unit. Sorry. Next, please, Frank. Okay, so you have at first this mask that is the summary, the transmitter summary. So basically all the elements, and as you can see, the red symbol is an indication, is located in the indication where the operation is not proper, is not correct. Next, please, Frank. Perfect. In this one, for instance, you have the configuration of the forward and reflected power, because on the output, on the final output of the transmitters of the transmitter after the combining, the matching of all the power amplifiers, you have a directional coupler with four probes. So two of these probes are for provide the forward and reflected to the control transmitter unit. Then the other two are available on the front of the transmitter, has probes where you can connect your spectrum analyzer or some kind of video analyzer digital or analog video analyzer in order to check all the major important parameters by yourself. Next, please. Perfect. This is the mask that will show you the status of the exciter. So basically, which one is on air, which one is off air, and you can select always through a very intuitive section that you can see on the right size of on the right side of the screen. You can select which one of the exciter have to be the main and which one the backup unit, the backup one. And also here you have all the very easily selection. You can change from manual to automatic configuration. So basically the exchange will be made automatically or manually. It's up to you to decide which one of these. And after that you have the configuration about the which one of the two exciter it will be on or off. So basically main and backup unit. And also the configuration and the condition of the coaxial switch that is managing the radio frequency output between the radio frequency connection between the exciter and the power amplifier. Next, please. Perfect. Here you have the resume of all of the single unit of the single unit of the power amplifier drawer. So this means that you have also the unbalanced power between the amplifiers on the combiners, and you can check also if there is any kind of unbalanced power on the combiner. Generally, these elements are set directly in the factory, and you do not need to tune anything. Also, because the all the modules, the power amplifier are in wide band, and so basically they are factory tuned, but in any case the technician, if they are specialized in these, they can in any case check the status of the transmitter after a long period of operation. Next, please. Perfect. In this configuration you have you can select the status of the exciter, so basically you can change the configuration between operation mode, local or remote. You can check if the radio frequency is present or absent. You can check, for instance, the operation mode, and this is the very important key point of this transmitter. This transmitter can easily switch from analog television to digital television mode operation mode. So you have only to provide the input of the analog signal if you want to transmit analog. You have to provide an ASI or a BTS or IP stream in case that you like to operate in digital. And then through these control panel units, you are capable to move from the analog transmission mode to the digital transmission mode or vice versa just by pushing the button on the transmitter supervisor. And next, please. Perfect. This is the configuration that that is basically the resuming of the power amplifier. As you can see, you see from starting from the bottom of the configuration, starting from the left to the right, you can see the input with the attenuators, then the driver amplifiers, and then the final three stages power amplifier, and then the final directional coupler that can provide easily directly at the transmitting sites all the major important information for the each one of the power amplifier drawers. Oh, this is very important because all this information are resumed inside to the transmitter supervisor, the central control unit, but all these elements, due to the fact that the central control unit has a built-in web browser, all these elements can be checked and can be seen directly from remote in every part of the world, only by the connection of the amplifier to the internet line and a PC with the proper IP addresses. You can check everything in every part of the world where you are located. Next, please. Perfect. Here we have also another mass that is the resuming of the voltages, heat sink temperature, power input and output, forward and reflected, and all the current, the currents of each one of the power amplifier and device inside to the power amplifier drawers. These elements can be all downloaded or extracted from the units. They can be stored and they can be put in a record for further analysis, or in the case that you want to see or want to go check, back to check something. In any case, all these parameters and all these elements can be extracted from the logic unit and can be stored in a record. Next, please. Frank, sorry, can you move to the next? Hello? Sorry, Frank. Frank, can you move to the next? Hello? Something happened? Hello, perfect. Here we are again. Sorry for the misunderstanding, for the mismatching. Oh. Our operation. Sometimes something happened during this world connecting. So basically here we are at the history. Basically this logic unit has inside a complete system of history. There is the resuming of the event log where we have all the indication and all the informations about the event that happened on the transmitter. So basically, time, day, and kind of event that happened in the transmitter. So all these elements are resuming that inside to these available screen. Also, this screen is always available for you at the transmitting side or by remote through the web browser, the built-in web browser. And moreover, you can also, in this case, save in a record all these elements of the events, and that can be inside to your to the history of your transmitter and transmitter operation condition. So as anticipated before, with an additional software that is loaded in the moment of the manufacturing of the transmitter, basically the transmitter is capable to operate the same control unit is capable to manage the 1+1 system configuration in order to show you more of the all slides that previously saw, also the A and B configuration transmitter. So basically the 1+1 passive reserve configuration. And you can move all these elements by the same logic unit, locally or by remote. As anticipated as well, the logic unit is capable to manage all the n plus one configuration, where for us the n has a maximum number of 9 transmitters. Generally, why we stop to 9? Generally, we stop to 9 because after this configuration, the insertion loss of the combiner's insertion, the combiner insertion loss becomes too high again. So basically, 9 is more or less the limit of the convenience to build up an n plus one system. After this level, insertion loss, combiner's insertion loss becomes too high, and generally, if except some case that really not often happen, is inconvenient because there is too much insertion loss. Perfect. So we can now give a brief introduction of the exciter because we already talked a lot in our previous webinars about these multi-mode exciters. And in any case, if you need additional information on this unit, you are free to contact us anytime, and we will be much more than happy to provide you all the information you may need. Basically, this low-power multi-mode exciter is 1 watt RMS built up in only one unit rack, and it is multi-mode because it is capable, thanks to the digital board, digital modulator inside, is capable to match all the digital and the analog standard for the global broadcasting. So here we can have a view of the front and the back. This unit is the same for all our transmitter, air or liquid cooled, but it can be used also as a standalone transmitter for low power transmission. One of the most important options of this unit is the possibility to have an satellite receiver with CAM, with the CAM built in. So basically you can receive directly from the satellite, you can connect the input that is coming from the LNB of your parabolic antenna directly to the to the exciter, and then you can rebroadcast automatically all the configuration. As I mentioned, the CAM is also available. There is also the slot to insert the CAM. Perfect. We can move a little bit in order to talk shortly about this technology. Basically, ProTelevision Technology is a company with a very high experience on the digital modulation, and it was in past part of the group of the Philips Group. And they start a lot of years ago developing the digital modulators, and it is one of the most provable and performable in the world. The most important thing of this equipment, this board, is for instance the opti power, that is a special algorithm that is capable to increase from 2 up to 5% the efficiency of your power transmitter, power amplifier. And the most important element is a very user-friendly user and intuitive web graphic user. So this configuration show the exciter panel of control, where through the operation of the drag and drop you can organize all the settings and the setup of the digital modulator. As we mentioned, we have directly inside linear and nonlinear precorrection. Moreover, this system has a special estimator that is capable to provide you directly the mare and shoulder elements of the value of the transmitter. Here, just an indication where we mention again that the exciter, the multi-mode exciter, can work on analog television and digital television. As for instance, the digital television, we are capable to apply the ISDBT or the main other digital modulation. And here we have a brief introduction about the advantages of the digital modulation that can offer you the possibility to operate in multi-frequency network or single frequency network operation. Moreover, the digital modulation gives you the advantage to use all the spectrum band. So in the previous analog operation mode, you need to leave one channel off guard. Instead, with the digital one, you can use the adjacent or co-adjacent channel. So this means that for the analog, you can use the channel, for instance, 24, then the 26, then the 28. For the digital, you can use 24, 25, 26, of course, using the critical mask filters and critical mask combiners. Here, a short introduction about the constellation, but we will talk again about this in our next webinars. And the digital modulator configuration for the ISDVT with the Remux. We can have the Remux option available inside. All the operations are drag and drop, so this means that it's enough to click on the square area that you need and track and release inside to the lower part, and you will go to activate the function and you can apply all the modification. So advantage of digital technology is very simple. So you will reduce the cost increasing the number of programs per channel and opening to the plurality of information. Then just to mention that this board with different software, our digital modulator board with a different software, is capable also for DAB and DAB Plus and TDMB technology for the digital audio broadcasting. Then we are basically at the end of our webinar. We apologize about the inconvenience that we lost the connection with our colleagues and friend, Mr. Frank Massa. I am very glad to have you as a participant to this webinar. You are free to send us informations requirement of information through the link connection or by mail, and we will be much more than happy to reply as soon as possible, of course. So thanks again for to join us to this webinar. We review the next appointment in the next 15 days, where we will go to introduce our liquid cooled transmitter line, the Nortia one. And basically we hope to see you soon again and to have you as our guest to this next webinar. Thanks a lot, and we hope to see you soon again.